What are aggregate objects in domain-driven design? Why we need the concept of aggregation in domain-driven design? To understand aggregates, we need to understand what is the problem that they are trying to solve. In domain-driven design, the relationships between objects are very complex. It's very difficult to find where the relationship starts, where the relationship ends. Let's take an example of person. Person has address. If we delete person, do we need to delete address? What if this address is being used by other people? If we don't delete addresses, then we have too much junk data. Nobody uses in the database. So these are decisions which are very hard. Object-oriented model or domain-driven design represents the real-life complex problem. So these domain models, they represent the complex realities of the world about the relationships, boundaries of the relationships, where the relationship is starting, where is it is ending. To add to this problem, there could be multiple clients which may be updating person's address. There may be order shipped to person and some other process may change his address and you have inconsistent data. And to add to this, there are business rules. Whenever some changes happen to object model, these business rules should not be violated. Whenever some change happens in our system, we cannot update all the objects. We cannot lock all the database to fix the problem of scoping. Here comes aggregates. Aggregates is cluster of related objects which we treat as a unit value for the data change. Aggregates provides the abstraction for encapsulating reference objects in the system. Let's take a real example in the world. If somebody is suffering from infection, he goes to the hospital. This is called encounter, and information is recorded. What is the date he's admitted? What is his address? What is his billing information? And then he's diagnosed. Why he came with a problem? So first there's a primary diagnosis. So first there's a primary diagnosis. He came with a problem, main infection. So he may have other problems also while diagnosing his problem, you may find, okay, besides infection, his blood pressure is too high. You may find other conditions also. Those are called secondary diagnosis. And then you perform some medical procedures on the patient to cure him. So the procedure performed to fix the primary diagnosis is called primary procedure. And there may be other procedures to stabilize his high blood pressure. Those are all called secondary procedures. And there may be his diagnosis doctor may be different, and the doctor who performs surgeries is different. So in this encounter, you are maintaining all the information about his diagnosis, his procedures, doctors who perform the diagnosis, doctors who perform the procedures. To the outside world, they just deal with encounter. So that's first thing about aggregate is there's a one root object, and it is the point of interaction with all the clients. All other applications deal with whole object hierarchy through this encounter object, which is a root object. Generally, it's single. It's difficult to be, it's always lonely at the top. So suppose you delete encounter. So encounter object has to make sure, so and the end of the year, you are clearing all the encounters. And the end of the year, you are deleting all the patient records. So if you delete an encounter, so this root object has to make sure that it need to delete all the procedures, all the diagnoses, and all the doctor's information who performed the diagnosis, and doctor's information who performed the procedures. So friends, we saw why we need aggregate. It is a mechanism by which we can club multiple objects in a one object and treat them as a one unit. So friends, thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, like it, share it, and subscribe to my channel for your regular updates. Also connect with me on LinkedIn and Twitter, especially LinkedIn if you like small summaries of the video. I will be posting a lot of small summaries of the video on LinkedIn. Thanks again.